but living in Handsworth, 14, I'm looking for something actively to do. I've seen this demonstration of kickboxing in Handsworth Park. I'm in love with the sport now.
Number one in the boxing ring, Kash the Flash, go teach you something.
I started as a young 14-year-old kid in Handsworth Park. I went down there, I used to play football a lot, very active childhood, and I seen a demonstration of a kickboxing demonstration. I was a big boxing fan. It was Howard Brown and Godfrey Butler. And then they started a class over at the local leisure centre. I went down there and I had a go. And I never stopped since and became my life. I was running at the deep end, obviously. I trained with the top guys like Howard and Godfrey, and they had no worries. They could throw me in with the Lions. They was always confident about my ability. My first fight, they threw me in, I was 17 years old. Went down to London, and it must have lasted, what, 30 seconds. Sparring was always difficult for me. Spent a lot of the time on my own in the gym. There was no one else around. I didn't have any training partners. I mean, my coach Howard was there sometimes, some days, but obviously, because there's not a lot of money involved in the sport, you know, it's a lot of the time I was on my own and just in the gym. People go to shows and they see fighters kicking above the waist. What we class that as is full contact karate. When you kick to the legs, inside and out the legs, that's what we class as kickboxing. When your fighter can grapple, grab around the neck, throw them around, knee and elbow, that's what we call full Thai rules. I'm very lucky because I done all three.
The once I'd learned a technique without getting too technical, I showed it to him. It was a punch. We were sparring at the time. But this is how you do this punch. It was a left hook. I said, it's called a long left hook. And I said, you do like this. That's it. Carried on sparring. It must have been about 10 seconds later. I was looking up at the lights. And I thought, well, I'm looking up at the lights and I'm standing up. I wasn't standing up. I was on my back. So I craned my neck up off the floor and looked at Kash. Well, really, he should have been concerned. I'm his coach. I'm smaller than him. He was going, it works. It works. That's Kash.
Obviously, it's a contact sport, what we're doing, and it's very dangerous. Whenever we get in that ring, someone is coming to hurt us, and we're thinking the same, we're going to hurt them. I've been quite lucky in my career. The only really serious injury I had, probably a broken jaw in two places, centre and the side, wired up for 6 weeks. See, I was training with Howard Brown, and his coach was Master Toddy. He was king of Thai boxing. He's the one who brought Thai boxing to the UK back in the early 70s. When we went to do low kicks and knee and the grappling for Thai boxing, Howard took me to Manchester with him, and I started to spend more time with Master Toddy, who's now Grand Master Toddy. He spent a lot of time in Thailand. So it was Master Toddy and Master Ray, two brothers, great trainers, great motivators. You know, I had some tough fights with the Thais. Obviously, Master Toddy, he loved me because I was a warrior. And anyone from Thailand, they love warrior mentality. After them two fights, they wanted me to go out to Thailand and spend 6 months there. But I was quite young and I didn't want to go out of the UK. So looking back at it now, maybe I should have gone. But then that's the way life is.
When you go in that ring, if you're not a warrior, you'll get hurt, you'll get beat. Kash went in as a warrior and never ever knew when he was beat.
During Kash's career, he fought a host of well-renowned fighters, most notably Alex Chewy in 1991. Kash was world amateur kickboxing champion and British and European champion at the age of just 24.
Alex Chewy from Australia, you know, unknown quantity, he came down and he came to win. That fight, I tell you what, round three, round four, I felt like giving up. The only reason I didn't give up was because my dad was in the crowd. If I gave up, he would have given me a beating when I got home.
He's obviously went on to be the 4 times world champion kickboxer. First Asian I ever saw in martial arts, a world champion. So, wow, I'm very, very proud of him. He's a legend in his field. And not only that for himself, but, you know, he gave so much back to the community.
Obviously, fighting, I used to do big promotions. And back in the day when I was fighting Howard Brown shows, when Howard was defending the title, I was an up-and-coming fighter. And people like UB40 used to come and watch. You know, UB40, I used to be a UB40 fan. And the after-parties, we used to go next door to Howard's house and Brian Travers and Ali Campbell, all the big names from UB40 used to be at the parties as well. So they became fans of mine. And, you know, they used to be raving about Kash the Flash because I was an Asian fighter. I stood out from anybody else.
Growing up in the city of Handsworth, we were a mixed community. Racism didn't really exist in my own area, but when I went away on the circuit fighting, sometimes people would call me racist names and boos and chants, but you know what? It didn't bother me. If I was in the ring fighting, someone might say, come on, you packy, or beat the packy, or kill the packy. Or what does that mean when you're in the ring fighting?
Despite being one of the most famous Asian fighters in the UK, Kash has grown up in Handsworth, notorious for being one of the roughest areas in Birmingham.
Handsworth is famous for the wrong reasons. It's famous for the high crime rate.
100th Riot back in the 80s. Obviously, I grew up in that era, you know, so all the BNP marches and stuff. But for me, 100th is a fantastic era. I loved it. We had a good mix of the kids. We had blacks, white, Asians. We all mixed together. There's a lot of unity in the community. Asian parents of the children taking part in sport, it doesn't really exist. Since I've come along, we've changed things. When I first went home to my father, I said, Dad, I want to do kickboxing. My dad, I could not believe it, how much he encouraged me to go down and take part. He said, son, what a fantastic move. He said, go and have a go. So I went down there and he was so proud. And he said, it's good to keep his sport. Because he was a former wrestler himself back in the Punjab, back in India, where obviously our roots are. Because he was a wrestler, he loved sport. And he encouraged me loads. And, you know, when I was to diet, he could not understand how my dieting worked because it was completely different to his. Because his was eat, eat, eat. Mine was starve, starve, starve.
Yeah, the song that I wrote for Kash was actually based off a song that I already released called Chokde. So number one in the boxing ring, Kash the Flash could teach you something. And just rewrote the whole Chokde, the Mabala when you see Kash the Flash, Chok. And he loved it. And, you know, it's written specially for him and he's been using it, you know, to come into the ring and everything. So I'm very proud. I've seen Kash fight live, and when you, to tell you the truth, when you see your friend in the ring, first thing, you don't want him to get hurt. You're like, that is okay. But yeah, I mean, wow. You know, when you've grown up with somebody, then you see them in the ring, I was just so proud of him and how he works. And you don't see that when you know, maybe when someone comes to see me and they see you on concert, they say, okay, wow. They see you in a completely different light, very, very professional, a very community person. He's not just fighting for himself, it seems like he's fighting for his family, he's fighting for his reputation, he's fighting for the community, he's very, very proud of Birmingham as well. So you get that sense when he's in the ring. So yeah, I've seen him a few times and I've watched lots of his fights on YouTube. Totally amazing, absolutely gifted, talented, legend in the ring. Inspirational to watch him.
I'm Kashi's brother. It's 2 years between us. So we've grown up quite close throughout our childhood, and we're still very close now. Where we've grown up, he's like a legend now. He's been very dedicated, lived a very disciplined lifestyle, and he deserves all the success he's got. Our dad was very supportive to us. He encouraged us into sport, so I think sport was a way out for us. It was a hard upbringing, but we grew up very close. You know, like, it wasn't about PCs and PlayStations them days. It was just about being out, playing in the parks.
I've got four brothers and a sister. Lost that mum very early. When I look at my mother passing away at such a young age, when I was 9 years old, it didn't really affect me as a child. But when I look at myself as a father and my children, if they lost their mother, it would be heartbreaking.
My personal time is spent with my three kids. You know, my kids are growing up now. I've got a daughter who's 19, got two young boys, 16 and 12. You know, I'm kind of glad they've gone in their own ways. My daughter just gone to university studying law, and I've got two lads who are very into football, very sporty, very active. My younger one's just gone into athletics as well. It represents the district. I'm kind of glad they've not followed my footsteps, you know, because I didn't want to force them into doing any martial arts. And I think I've encouraged any other kid except my own.
The childhood that I didn't have, I wanted them to have better than what I had, and I tried my best to give them that. My separation with Julie's a great girl. It was a difficult one when it came to the split, because it wasn't my decision. But I think maybe what happened, I got really, really busy with my gym. So it did cause a lot of problems because I wasn't spending enough time, but I think it did contribute towards it. But Julie was a great girl, and if I had to go back in time, I would do it all again.
Since retiring from kickboxing, obviously, it's my life. I went to the gym, and that's where I spend all my time now, in the gym. And just for the kids here, I know I get a lot of fun training these kids and changing their lives, you know, coming to them and seeing the self-defense, keeping them fit, getting their belts, you know, but they then get the gradings as well, take red, white, yellow, right through to black belt. But the stuff that I didn't have, I wanted everyone else to have for themselves.
Great guy outside the ring, done so much for his community. A proud Brummie, and we're proud to have him as well, I think it's the important thing. Doesn't get enough credit at times for what he does for the community, because kickboxing not being one of the great national sports like football or cricket or regular boxing, but he's done an amazing job.
Fighting is my life, and I never done it for any financial rewards. I never once asked what's the purses for a fight. You know, I wasn't doing it for money. You know, I didn't make any money out of fighting. It wasn't about money. It's just winning a nice trophy and seeing the world and traveling. You know, I've got a lot of passion for fighting. A lot of the guys in today's society do it for the financial reward. And if you do anything for money, you ain't gonna make it. You know, my struggles in life is like everybody else. You know, I have to work hard for what I do. So we've got no financial backing from anyone. You know, no one supports us. So life is tough, you know, it's difficult. But, you know, I am a fighter, so I never give in. You know, I'm hoping, you know, things will change over the near future. You know, the sport of kickboxing will get a governing body one day. But, you know, I've been saying that for 25, 30 years. It's not happened. Kash Flash Gym was my dream, and I produced 6 world champions. I'm very proud of that. Obviously, producing a world champion takes a lot of time and dedication. You know, even with my own personal life, it affected it because obviously kids' birthdays and all that, but my fighters were part of the family as well. Kash Flash, in the next 5-10 years, I'm going to always be active in the martial arts and I'll always be coaching at the gym.
Number one in the boxing ring, Kash the Flash go teach you something. Oh, when him come, I know you better watch out. Tara come off in office cream and shout.